For me, the Fiorlitzdelieder, the four last songs, are extremely compelling, unspeakably beautiful, and just the absolute musical depiction of that transfiguration from life to death, and something that we as humans will never fully understand. Each one of them is the most magical conversation between orchestra and voice, an absolute gift for a singer. What I love about them is that they go through all of those feelings of anxiety, of acceptance, of elation and rest. These poems, they offered an alternative possibility of the afterlife, and I think that that was very much part of Richard Strauss's own research and therapy for himself, wanting to prepare himself for any eventuality. Fühling, the first one, is about the poet wanting to not really believe that he won't ever experience a spring again, because it's something that is so familiar. It's the smells, it's the sounds, it's totally tangible to them in that moment. And then September is, I guess, the autumn. Well, it talks a lot about moisture and cooling and the garden becoming, not sodden, but the cool rain seeps into the flowers and the summertime shudders, waiting for its end. This is the movement towards the end. The expiry is near, the winter of our lives is near. And it doesn't actually go into the winter, it goes into the flight. And that is by Schlafengehen. That one there is hibernation to me. So I guess it is winter in that way. It's the releasing yourself to that permanent sleep, or that, you know, that wonderful heavy feeling. Feels like you're literally falling asleep. Then in the last stanza of the poem is the soul rising up to wherever it goes. And then you have Im Abendrot, the sunset, and beautifully the Im Abendrot talks about wandering through eternity with this person that they are so connected to and so familiar with. It's just incredibly moving. The last line is this perhaps death. It's almost as though this is so peaceful and beautiful, and a sense of calm and peace that I haven't experienced for a long time in my awake life. With Strauss, I think for me, everything he writes has a depth of emotional connection that I don't experience very often with other composers. I pretty much love everything he does. He can do no wrong for me. His singing for voice is, I think, kind of unmatched because of his intimate understanding of particularly the soprano voice. His wife was a soprano, and it was very much a sound and, I suppose, a medium of music that he was very more familiar with than anything else, apart from, you know, the orchestra and other things that he wrote for. But in terms of high emotion, a lot of the time was that soprano voice. It's the Beim Schlafengehen that gets me every time. There are moments of every single one of these songs that just completely disarming. They just floor me every time. But that is the one that I find very difficult to sing without weeping. It's that feeling of release. I don't think I have to worry about going through being exhausted by the emotion of it. Vocally, I'm having to prepare them with a slightly different approach to what I would if I was not doing them with a ballet company. What I've had to do is actually sing through them at the tempi of the recording that the choreographer has used, which is the very famous Jesse Norman recording with Kurt Mazur. There are a lot of moments where Jesse Norman takes time over a bar line, like every two bars. She has this wonderful ability to seamlessly restart a line, but in order to do that, she's phrasing them with length so there's nothing snatched or hurried. Her interpretation, to me, it's like she's looking after and treasuring every bit of what Strauss has written. To have the opportunity to sing these 11 times with orchestra is something I would never have dreamed of being able to do, because every single time I perform them, it changes me because I love them so much, and each time will be a joy. It's a very different experience singing with the ballet. that extra layer of expression through movement and dance brings another layer of understanding to the music. They speak to an essential part of our being, which is the autumn of life that we all experience.